Next, what happened? The Germans took my father, my brother, and my older sisters to chop stones, and they even chopped the cemetery. I think that the Germans, what they wanted to do is not to let live the living and also the dead, not give them peace either. So they were taken to the cemeteries every day to chop the stones and make the roads. So this was for a short while. That's what they actually were doing. And I stayed with my mother on the farm still.
Was these Christian cemeteries, Jewish cemeteries?
This was a Jewish cemetery. And it was very painful. My father used to come home and cry that because I think to him it was the most sinful act to participate in, because it was quite sacred, a stone with a prayer on it, to chop it up, and he had to do it.
At this point, were you forced to wear any badges or?
Yes, we were actually, all of us, we were already branded. We had to wear a Star of David, all of us, and that already made me feel very different. I felt branded, different, and I didn't know who I was anymore.
Did you attend school at this time? Were you still going to school at this time?
No, we were not allowed, no, none of us were allowed to any school at all. We were not going to school, and we were just waiting what's next, because I knew, and my parents knew, that nothing better is there to come. So what my parents decided to do, to dismantle all the equipment that we had, machinery, all kinds of machinery that we used to make crops and milk and butter and ice cream, and to distribute it amongst all the Gentile people that we knew in the village, with the thought that if we need a favor from them, we will probably be able to ask them. And they always said, "Oh, we'll be glad to help you in any way." So my parents were busy doing this every night, and my sisters and my brother were helping them. So they were taking it and just distributing. But most of the property they were doing is for Heinka and Vladek, not knowing that later on they would be the only ones that helped us out.
But you were still allowed to live in your home.
We were still living in our home, and then we also found out that they appointed Mushinsky to manage our farm. We lived at home, but we had no authority to do anything or to be in charge of the property at all. And we knew that this is a very short time, because not to. It didn't take too long of a time when the sheriff and the Gestapo came to our home, and they came for my ear. They actually came to take away my brother and my father.